Oh.
All right, good evening, everybody. Welcome to Jazz Record Art Collective here at the Fulton Street Collective. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. Tonight, we're proud to present Nickolas Kaplan Quintet and Quartet, performing two Herbie Hancock records, Empyrean Isle from 1964 and Maiden Voyage from 1965. As we do with all of our performances here, always accompanied by a visual artist. Tonight, in the lower right-hand side of your screen, if you're watching from home, is Arthur Wright. Give it up for Arthur. Arthur will be sketching and painting the band as they perform, and what is really cool is you can buy his artwork in the lower left-hand side of the screen. That is the virtual tip jar. That's how you tip the band. If you're watching in the comfort of your own home, why not do the right thing and tip the band? It's healthy for you. All right, we're going to get started here. On drums is Frank Morrison. Evan Levine on bass. Elio Wajaya on piano. And on trumpet, leading the crew tonight, Nickolas Kaplan.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. How are we feeling this evening? Good? Good. Thanks for coming out on this lovely Wednesday evening. For those of you who are joining us in person or over the Al Gore's internet, as they say, we do appreciate each and every one of you for tuning in tonight. So these albums tonight, we're starting with Empyrean Isles, and on the second set a little later, you're going to hear Maiden Voyage. They're two albums recorded over the course of two different years, but they share a lot of similarities. As you'll notice, our guest artist, Arthur Wright, in the bottom right hand of your screen, another hand for him, he's doing a lot of aquatic-inspired art this evening, and that's very fitting. Both of these albums are inspired by the sea. They're inspired by, you know, man's or woman's search in the wilderness, in the sea, sea creatures, mythology. There's a lot of overlap with his, you know, Miles Davis bandmate Wayne Shorter, who both, you know, really loved these kind of different concepts. And so both of these are concept albums with pretty much the same personnel. Both of these albums have Freddie Hubbard, Herbie Hancock, Ron Carter, and Tony Williams. Later we're going to be joined by Kenneth Leffridge Jr. Taking on the mantle of Big G, George Coleman, on Maiden Voyage. This next tune, well, that first tune, first of all, if you take your hand out and try to make a one-finger snap, you'll find that it is impossible. And some people would argue that Herbie Hancock's imagination is sometimes fantastical. But Herbie Hancock came from Chicago, Illinois. If you, you know, go on Instagram or something, there's this, you know, image that circulated of his business card back when he lived in Hyde Park, where he was born and raised. Studied at the Chicago Conservatory of Music and then went to Grinnell for electrical engineering, which is where you got a lot of that headhunter stuff later on. But Herbie is a native son of Chicago, and so we are thrilled to bring his music alive in the city where he was born and raised. This next tune will take you another region of the Empyrean Isles. This one is the Oliloquy Valley. Oliloquy Valley. Thank you. There we go. Thank you. Aliloquy Valley. Again, for those of you just joining us, this is Leo Wijaya on the piano. And behind me is Evan Salvacion Levine on the bass. And rounding out the rhythm section, Mr. Frank Morrison on the drums. So for those of you who are BAM heads out there, and we say BAM heads, not jazz heads, if you know, you know. But if you want to learn more afterwards, come see me during the set break. We're going to take a little departure from Empyrean Isles. As those of you know, it's a four-track album, and in the old days of recording, that usually amounted to 36 to 40 minutes, and we think your first set should be a little bit longer with that, but we're going to take another tune from the Herbie Hancock library. This one is, I'd like to think, one of his more politically oriented tunes. Was written in around 1967 or so. Originally appeared on his album Speak Like a Child, then later appeared on Nefertiti. Martin Luther King once said, "A riot is the language of the unheard." We're going to now play for you Herbie Hancock's Riot.
Thank you.
Herbie Hancock, Riot. All right. Gonna go back to Empyrean Isles. Man, I know you all love this next tune, but I'm gonna give it a little backstory for a second, just rest my chops. So the other day, while I was looking for some new threads for this show, I walked into the Herbie Hancock store, Fashion Couture, and unfortunately they were out of the cantaloupe shirt, so instead I picked myself up a watermelon shirt, as you can see here. But still Herbie, because his very first album had Watermelon Man, and this song is similarly Chicago-inspired. It harkens time to the days when 43rd Street on down had bustling music. You used to hear boogaloo like this. And this one, of course, is Cantaloupe Island, played a la Chicago 1960s. Cantaloupe Island. Thank you. Cantaloupe Island. Well, this set has one last doo-wackle for you. Before that, I was just thinking just the other day, while we were talking a little bit at rehearsal, all of us in this band now are approximately about the ages of the people on this original album, which, I don't know, it seemed we were split between whether that was good or depressing news. But I really love this band because I feel each individual member really embodies the spirit of their counterparts on the album. Elio filling in for Herbie, Evan filling in for Ron Carter, and of course Frank filling in for Tony Williams. Tony Williams, big shoes to fill there, but you're filling them in well over there. You're doing okay. Tony would be happy. I'm happy Tony would be happy. I'm going to conclude this one with, man, you know, this tune was so obscure I couldn't even save myself a little time transcribing by finding on the internet. This one is called The Egg. But as it turns out, Evan was telling me during rehearsal, Nick, it's just, you know, it's just sketches and modes and stuff. You're overthinking this, you know. You know me, of course I would. But we're going to conclude this one with The Egg. And this is going to prelude a little bit of Maiden Voyage by taking us into some free territory. Here is Herbie Hancock's The Egg. Thank you. Thank you very much. That is sides one and two of Empyrean Isles. We will be back with Maiden Voyage. And thank you for sticking around. Hope you enjoy. For those of you who are enjoying from home, don't forget to tip the tip jar. Luke Kula, I see you. Thank you for being a mensch. Others out there, make sure to tip the jar. The jar is very happy the more money it gets. And we appreciate you so much for joining us, whether in person or in the comfort of your home. Thank you for supporting live music and the Fulton Street Collective. the song ended.
Thank you, guys.
All right, we are back. Welcome to round two, album two, Maiden Voyage. On drums, Frank Morrison. Evan Levine on bass. Ilya Wajaya, piano. Just joining us on tenor saxophone, Kenneth Leftridge Jr. And leading the crew tonight on trumpet, Nickolas Kaplan. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. That was Maiden Voyage, the title track from this set, Maiden Voyage by Herbie Hancock in 1965. This album kind of takes some of the concepts and thematics from Empyrean Isles and builds on them. And you also hear sharp influence from his time in the Miles Davis quintet, where all of the musicians on the album were derived from. Herbie Hancock, of course, Ron Carter, and Tony Williams. Little known fact that George Coleman was also a Miles Davis quintet member for some time in the 60s on such albums as Seven Steps to Heaven. And then filling in on the trumpet chair, of course, is Freddie Hubbard. So that was Maiden Voyage. This next song, this is another concept album, much like Empyrean Isles. This is kind of meant to capture the volatility of the sea. I think in the program notes I put on Facebook, Herbie Hancock himself writes a very interesting kind of soliloquy in the liner notes. And this next one is captures the tumult of a seafarer who finds themselves in the eye of the hurricane.
Thank you. Thank you.
I have the hurricane. So earlier on the first set, we played a bonus track from another album by Herbie and Miles Davis. This one actually follows a similar story in that it originally appeared on a Miles Davis album called ESP that featured most of the band, minus George and Freddie, of course. And then Herbie brought it back in for this band with Freddie Hubbard and George Coleman instead on the horns. This one captures the... we announced the egg. Did I not announce the name of the egg on the first set? I'm trying to remember, because this one actually has a continuity from the egg in the first set, kind of the very birth of life, to the precarity of life on this tune, which is called Little One. Imagine like a little seal or baby dolphin in the middle of an uncertain ocean. You can hear the ripples and the predators and just the precarity of life. So this one is called Little One.
Thank you. Thank you.
little one. Got a couple more for you. Sometimes in the midst of the sea, it can be a fight for every fish and every sea urchin and every sea creature battling out in the midst to survive the next day to the next day to continue the species. This one captures that mood, I think, very effectively, and this is Herbie Hancock's Survival of the Fittest. Survival of the Fittest.
Mm-hmm.
Survival of the fittest. We have one more for you all. Thank you very much for attending in person, for watching from home. We appreciate each and every one of you. If you've been inspired by the music tonight, we encourage you to inspire the band. We have a tip jar down in the right-hand corner of your screen. If you are in person and so interested, feel free to kibosh with me a little bit after the show. We also have a fantastic artist who is creating a lot of very interesting multimedia works there with sea creatures and musicians. Some would say they're much the same, but a hand for Arthur Wright. A hand for Arthur Wright. You know, as I always say, Arthur is one of my favorite, if not my favorite artist, as part of this JRAC series. Recently was honored with having his artwork be the feature portrait for the Chicago Jazz Festival. So an amazing accomplishment for Arthur. So for those of you familiar with the music this evening, there's a lot of mix of more obscure tunes and more, as are called, jazz standards. A couple of them from the first set, like Cantaloupe Island and, of course, Maiden Voyage from this one fit into that. This last one also falls into that canon. This one is aptly called Dolphin Dance. We hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
All right, that's the Maiden Voyage, everybody. Frank Morrison is on drums tonight. Evan Levine on bass. Elio Wajaya on piano. Special guest on tenor saxophone, Kenneth Leftridge Jr. And leading the crew tonight for both records on trumpet, Nickolas Kaplan. So if you're watching from home, it's time to get fancy with your phones and tip the band. Bring out that fancy bank app with your fancy phone and be generous and be kind. It makes you healthy. If you're in the house, we're going to turn on the lights, take a look at Arthur's work, which is phenomenal, on the blast door over here. Give it up for Arthur Wright. We're back here tomorrow night with another live stream, and we will see you then. Until then, stay safe. Have a good night, everybody.